to Patrick TV. I'm happy to see you, and I hope you're happy to see me too. In this episode, we are talking about preparing for pensions. For so many people, they, especially even in the informal sector, many get to 60 and they are still working, cracking their knuckles to make ends meet. I'm going to find out today how one can adequately prepare for pensions. And as usual, this program is brought to you by the Chum Purchase and Sole Distributors of Kiss Me Energy Drink. And we also have New Executive School, one of the top primary schools at Kaswa. And last, we have Invest Agriculture, sole distributors of some agricultural products. We'll be right back.
Good evening and welcome to Patrick TV. It's your savings tutor, Mr. Patrick Ban, with you this evening. This evening, we are going to discuss the topic retirement. I know it's a topic that interests most people. So therefore, today I want us to discuss how we can prepare for our retirement. Okay, I was just looking through some of the statistics on retirement and I realized that when you go to South Africa, about 90% of the people there have no retirement plan. When you come to Ghana, out of the 1.4 million people on retirement, only 7% of them are on pension. And this pension I'm talking about is the SNIT pension scheme. This is a very, very interesting and very damning report. So today I want us to look at how we can plan for our retirement. Many people will be saying that, oh, for me, I don't want to think about tomorrow. Tomorrow will think about itself. I don't want to be earning money so much for someone to take over when I die before my time. It's a very good and cogent idea or thing to think about. But what if you don't die? What if you get older? And what if you don't have money to plan whilst you cross the 60 years age? So today I want us to discuss this matter. And I want us to discuss this matter dispassionately. So I'm going to talk about two things that we all need to plan when it comes to our retirement. We have the personal and the financial planning. Now the personal has to do with what you are going to do whilst on retirement, where you are going to spend the retirement in terms of the house you are going to live in, where you are going to travel to, the businesses that you are going to do whilst on retirement. These are things that we need to sit down and write them down. You need to understand and put them down on the things that you want to do whilst on retirement. Now, the things that you are going to do whilst on retirement will bring us to the second part, which is the financial planning. That's where you need to plan how much money will I need after age 60 to when I die. How much money will I need to enjoy that traveling experience that you want to engage yourself in? How much money do I need to save so that when I'm on retirement, I don't need to bother my children, my grandchildren with money? Because don't forget that when you are retiring at the age of 60 going, that is where you will fall sick the most. Now, if you don't have any financial plan to cater for that age, you become a burden for your family. Your kids who are now married and they also have family will have to leave their families and be looking after you just because you decide not to plan for your retirement whilst you were 60 years, we are 30 years, you are 20 years, you are 40 years. So it's important that we have that financial plan. And how do we do this plan? Very simple. One, we need to open the retirement account at any of the banks in the country. Luckily for us, we have insurance companies in the country that have this wealth plan for retirement. Some start as low as 100 CDs, 200 CDs, 50 CDs. A plan that can go for, let's say, 30 years, 20 years. This is something that we should all engage ourselves in. Because by the time that you are going on retirement, if you had gone in for the 100 CDs package, you can imagine how much money you have plus the interest. Don't forget the compounding interest factor with your money. And this will become like a point of investment whilst you are on retirement. Now, when you retire and you have, let's say, 1 million Ghana cedis in your account, you just fix it as an investment package. Every 3 months, you go for your interest and you'll be spending that for the rest of your life before you die. And this is something that I think that when we do, it's going to impact our generation. Now, your kids will not have to now think about, oh, what is our dad going to do when he's on retirement? You have your retirement plan already in place, catering for you and your family. I believe that this evening you have enjoyed the discussion on retirement. is a very important topic that I believe that we should all be discussing at our homes. After listening to the discussion, the next thing is to take the step. Move to that bank, move to that financial institution and talk to them about this plan. Start that plan now, not tomorrow, not to the next week. It is now. Just as you are watching, just move to the bank or that insurance company and go and start that plan, because your future is as equally as important as now. I hope you have enjoyed today's discussion. I implore you to subscribe to the channel and share the link with your friends. We'll meet again next week. God bless you.